Ladies and gentlemen, we are Kiosk 3. I am Kaneta, this is Arika, and this is Mia. Let's go to the next slide. Now, the public service of Bangladesh is providing excellent service to its public, and it is being praised both locally and globally. But is it being able to reach that guy who has arsenicosis because of arsenic in their water? Is it being able to reach that man who has an open manhole in front of his house and can't even breathe properly? The problem is we are not reaching out to the public properly. We expect that public service will deliver us what we want, but in reality, we don't even have any choice to say what we want. We expect that we have easy accessibility during crisis. If we face a problem, it will be easily accessible to reach to the public service, but it is difficult and it is even possible. We expect that our feedback will be properly recognized, but most of the time it is unclear. We expect that the service will be delivered on time, but you see, in reality, it takes forever to even fix a lamp post. Move on. Now, this leads to dissatisfaction among the public to take any public service or to tell about their problems to the public service sectors. We see lack of trust, and this also leads to feeling unimportant because your voice, your opinion doesn't even matter, your feedback doesn't even matter. And this also leads to these symptoms leads to unwillingness towards taking any public service or to say what they have, what the problems. And we look for alternatives, like we tell our problems to the neighbor instead of actually going to the public service and addressing our problems. And we don't even provide our feedback or very little feedback. And most of the times we are victimized because that manhole which was open and the man couldn't even breathe, he actually fell inside the manhole because no time initiative was taken. Right, okay. Now, the problem does not lie in the public service. The problem lies that the public service isn't being able to reach to the proper people because they don't have the feedback mechanism to say what they want. So our objective is raising awareness and developing a proper feedback mechanism. Now, let's see what Anika has to say.
If we look into the SWOT analysis of the feedback mechanism, the main strength that we have is that the government gets to know what public wants. It is a simple demand-supply relation. If your demands are being catered for, you'll obviously want to access that service. And as a result, the people will have more trust on the public sector services. The weakness that we have is that since people's needs are and wishes are not being catered for and the proper feedback is not being taken, even if the feedback is taken, the proper actions are not being taken, people feel that their feedback is unimportant and as a result they are very unwilling to provide feedback. Even if they provide feedback, it's not very proper. The opportunity that we have is that if this feedback mechanism can be improved, the citizens will feel empowered, they'll feel important. This is because they'll feel that their problems are important enough that the government is doing something to solve that. And as a result, the gap that we have with the government, that we feel that the government does not cater to our needs, this gap will be bridged. And obviously there are some threats. The threats are from the private service sectors whom we address when we have any other problems. So what do we want to do? We want to position the feedback mechanism as something when people hear, they would be like, their feedback counts. Every feedback counts. They would feel important. And how are we going to do this? We are going to do this through a 4-step plan. And we want to generate hype among everybody regarding the feedback. That if you provide feedback, your feedback will be listened and accordingly the actions will be taken. So the target group that we identified are teenagers, rural community and the city dwellers. But our core target group is the rural community. This is because these are the people who face various sort of problems and they do not know whom should they address for their problems. And even if, since they are mostly uneducated and they form a big part of our population. Moving on. So our campaign is a 4-step plan. This comprises of the Yellow Army, Apunalai, which is a one-stop service center, Apnar Montopo, which is a TV reality show, and Ponpushor, which is a 24/7 dedicated hotline. Step 1, Step 2, and Step 4 will be initiated from the beginning of our campaign. However, after 3 months, when the Yellow Army has already generated hype and has already identified certain problems in the mass, then we'll launch a TV reality show, which is Apnar Montopo. Okay, so Yellow Army. Yellow Army will be an army which will be formed, which will comprise of people from the public sector and as well as we would recruit from the mass. The reason we want to recruit from the mass is because we want them to be a part of something good. they'll feel important that they're doing something good for their own community, for themselves. And they will be provided with training programs so that they know how to handle a disaster. And they will also cater to any problem arising from any corner of the country, and they'll try to go and solve them. And after that, we would rank somebody as Apna Hero. This would be our local hero. And as a result, more and more people would feel that, let me do something else and let me be the hero of my community. Moving on. Phase 2, Aponalaya, which is a one-stop service center. For passport, we have to go to one office. For tax renewal, for paying tax, we have to go somewhere else. So this can be a hassle in some cases. So we want to, we suggest opening up a one-stop service which will be located in all sub-districts. This will be a one-stop center from where people can make bill payments, license renewals, and also voter ID registrations. This will also be a feedback center where people can go and provide their feedbacks and can also go and tell people about their problems. And this will be accessed through their national ID so that there is a record can be kept in the database about what problem did they talk about and who talked about the problem. And lastly, the information center will also provide information about all the authorities, procedures, and will also take on complete registrations.
So ladies and gentlemen, what do we have in phase 3? In phase 3, we are going to have a reality show, TV reality show that's called Apna Mohan. So what happens is, when we say that the reality show is named Apna Mohan, we're going to make the people feel empowered about themselves, that their feedback counts, that the feedback is something that actually matters. So for that, what we're going to do is, all the complaints that's been compiled by the Yellow Army, we're going to compile all the complaints and discuss it and address those issues in this reality show. And to create a big hype among the people, we're going to call upon celebrities. Celebrities like, we have Salman Muqtadir because he caters to the teenagers and the youth. And also we have Mumtaz because, as we said, that our primary target group is about, you know, the rural people. So she's a star of the rural people. And finally, we have Mundi Shah for the city dwellers, because these are the people who usually, you know, read a lot of newspapers and caters to the media and keeps updated with themselves, right? Phase 4, we have a contour show which talks about your voice. That is your one voice call away, your one phone call away from addressing your problems. And you know what, you never know that there might be a problem which can be changed and which can be, of course, solved. So what is it? It's about a toll-free hotline, which is 512, and it's totally accessible 24/7 at any time of the day. And we're also going to have immediate responses and feedback, that people are going to, you know, feel satisfied. Oh, I just called them and somehow I got this feedback instantly, and that's how we are going to grow satisfaction. And finally, we are going to file complaints, right? So moving on, we are going to see simultaneously we need embedded developments, because these are essential parts along with these four-step solutions. Number one, we are going to have an open a web page or a website, which is immensely important because people need to keep updated, go to the website if they have a problem or any kind of things, right? Then we have an e-consultation because there's a person who is going to be stay there online for 24 hours and probably they are going to change their schedules and someone else is going to replace him after a different interval. And we are going to keep tracks of all the complaints that's been filed and people could keep tracks of it. And finally, we have feedback portals and also information about one-stop booths. Moving on, along with this, for a huge advertisements, we need to affiliate with the radio because this is going to reach the mass populace. We're going to have billboards in cities and rural areas so that it attracts the attention of the people. We're also going to have badges to school children. So remember this, understand this. Once the school children go back to their school and the parents see this, like, what's that? And they can understand that there is an awareness about feedback mechanism, and that's how we cater to more populace. And finally, we have newsletters. That's how people get updated and the changes in the entire mechanism, right? So how do we monitor and evaluate the entire campaign? We are going to see the responses on Facebook page. We are going to see the number of complaints registered, whether it's increasing day by day or not. We are going to see the views on the videos that we upload about our show, and also frequency of call on the hotline, whether we see it's increasing or not every day passing by. So finally, ladies and gentlemen, what are the takeaways that we have brought you? We've told you about establishing a hotline, which is 512. We've told you about restoring the public faith in public service sectors. That's how people are going to understand, no, that the public service sector is something that's worth our time and filling complaints, right? We're going to engage the youth. We're going to engage them and involve them in the entire campaign and feel them empowered and make people know that these youth are helping us. And finally, the main objective, that is, we are going to reduce the sufferings of the people, that the mass populace that we are catering to. That's all from Chaos Theory. We would like to entertain any sort of questions that you guys want to ask.
Thank you. আচ্ছা আমি বাংলায় বলতে চাচ্ছি সেটা হচ্ছে আপনারা এখানে বসে আছেন না আপনাদের সামনে কেউ এখানে মেশিন দিতে পারে আপনারা যা করছেন এই পুরো আইডিয়াটা এই প্ল্যানটা ইমপ্লিমেন্টেশন করার ক্ষেত্রে আপনার কাছে কতটুকু বাংলাদেশের কনটেক্সট বিচার করে কতটুকু রিয়েলিস্টিক মনে হচ্ছে কতটুকু সম্ভব বা আপনাকে পুরো দায়িত্ব দিয়ে দেওয়া হবে যে আপনি কী কী চান আর কতটুকু সম্ভব
তো বাইরেন এখানে ডোন্ট ট্রাই টু ডিফেন্ড বি রিয়েলিস্টিক
আচ্ছা সো প্রবলেম যাদের হয় প্রবলেম যাদের হয় তারা হচ্ছে গ্রামের মানুষ যে বলতে পারছে না তাদের ল্যাম্পপোস্টটা সামনে নষ্ট তাদের বাসার টিন উড়ে গেছে এবার কিছু একটা সো ইয়েলো মাস যেটা ইয়েলো আর্মি যেটা আছে সেটা হচ্ছে প্রতি সাব ডিস্ট্রিক্টে থাকবে তারা বাসায় বাসায় মানুষের মাসের কাছে কাছে যেয়ে তাদের প্রবলেমগুলো অ্যাস্ক করবে দ্যাটস হাউ উই অ্যাক্সেস টু দ্য রুরাল পিপল যারা আর কি ফেসবুক চালাতে পারে না যারা আর কি মেবি
নেম রেজিস্ট্রেশন প্রসেসটাই জানে জানে এর জন্য
কত লোক লাগবে আপনাদের সারা দেশে
সরকারের কেমনে কি হয় এটা যেহেতু ওদের আইডিয়া আছে উই হ্যাভ টু হ্যাভ পিপল ফ্রম দি পাবলিক সেক্টর অ্যান্ড অ্যাজ ওয়েল অ্যাজ আমরা নিজে ওই কমিউনিটির লোকটা কারণ ওই লোকটা জানে ওর এলাকাতে সমস্যাটা কি এর জন্য উই উইল অলসো এমপ্লয় পিপল ফ্রম দ্যাট কমিউনিটি সো দ্যাট দে অলসো নো দেয়ার প্রবলেমস অ্যান্ড সাথে সাথে উই হ্যাভ পিপল হু নো অ্যাবাউট দ্য রুলস অ্যান্ড রেগুলেশন সো এই সাথে মিলে উইল ফর্ম দ্যাট ইয়েলো আর্মি সো দ্যাট আপনার একটা
যেহেতু
পাবলিক সেক্টর উই ডু নট হ্যাভ টু পে আ হাই প্রাইস অ্যান্ড প্রাইভেট সেক্টর উই পে আ হাই প্রাইস সো প্রাইভেট সেক্টরের কোয়ালিটি অবভিয়াসলি ওরা বেটার দেওয়ার চেষ্টা করে কারণ কি অনেক কম্পিটিটিভ একটা কোম্পানির সাথে একটা কোম্পানির কম্পিটিশন অনেক বেশি থাকে এর জন্য ওরা কী করবে যে যাতে ওরা কম্পিটিশনটা মেনটেন করতে পারে অ্যান্ড অন্য কোনো ব্র্যান্ডে শিফট না হয় ওরা কনস্ট্যান্টলি চেষ্টা করে ওদের সার্ভিসটাকে ইম্প্রুভ করার সম্ভব এই যে এখন
অনেক বেশি সম্ভব কারণ এটা প্রথমে ফ্রি এটা ফার্স্ট অফ অল এটা ফ্রি সো এটা যদি ঠিকমতো অ্যাপ্লাই করতে পারে ঠিকমতো মানুষের নিডগুলোকে মিট করতে পারে তাহলে মানুষ কেন টাকা দিয়ে পাবলিক সেক্টর থেকে হেল্প নিবে তাহলে তো গভর্নমেন্ট প্রাইভেট সেক্টর থেকে হেল্প নিবে তাহলে তো গভর্নমেন্টের কাছ থেকেই হেল্প নিবে আর যদি গভর্নমেন্ট তাদের আর গভর্নমেন্ট ইজ অলরেডি ফেসিং আ হিউজ কম্পিটিশন
তাদের কম্পিটিশনটা কিভাবে করে যাতে আপনারা বলছেন ফিডব্যাকটা ফিডব্যাক মেকানিজম আমার মনে হয় যে ফিডব্যাক মেকানিজম চাইতে আপনি যদি সাজেস্ট করতেন যে এনগেজমেন্ট আমি একটা ফিডব্যাক দিলাম হাজার হাজার ফিডব্যাক লক্ষ লক্ষ ফিডব্যাক আসলো যারা এলো কিন্তু কেউ কোনো রেসপন্স করলো না সেটা তো নিশ্চয় চান না তাই না এটা চান যে আমি অনেকগুলো ফিডব্যাক নিয়ে নিলাম কিন্তু কোনো কেউ উত্তর দিল না হ্যাঁ আমি শেষে কোনো উত্তর দিল না তাহলে এটা একটা ব্যাপার আছে আর একটা ব্যাপার আছে যে গভর্নমেন্টের মধ্যে যারা সার্ভিস প্রোভাইডার যারা আছে নতুন এই সিস্টেমটা চালু করার সময় তাদেরকে কীভাবে মোটিভেট করা যায় তাদের মাইন্ডসেট কীভাবে চেঞ্জ করা যায় তাদের কীভাবে আরও প্রিপেয়ার করা যায়
সম্ভব না যে ন্যাশনাল আইডি এই পার্ট গুলা ইজ গভর্নমেন্টস রেসপন্সিবিলিটি এন্ড এর সাথে উই ক্যান এনগেজ পিপল ফ্রম দ্য প্রাইভেট
অর্গানাইজেশনটা কি পাবলিক যাতে খুশি থাকে পাবলিক যাতে স্যাটিসফাইড হয় এইটাই কি অনেক বড় একটা ইম্পর্টেন্ট জিনিস না গভর্নমেন্টের জন্য
আমি আরো সহজ করে দিচ্ছি সার্ভিস ডেলিভারি বেটার করার জন্য জি গভর্নমেন্ট অফিসিয়াল যারা সার্ভিসটা দেয় জি তারা কি তাদের কিভাবে মোটিভেট করবে
আচ্ছা
তারা লিখবে না যদি না লিখে আপনাদের সিস্টেমে আপনি অনেক সুন্দর সিস্টেম দিবেন তাদেরকে হাতে হাতে ইন্টারনেট কানেক্ট
হোয়াট ইফ উই মেক দা আমার আপনি হিরো What if you make that hero the government officer who actually worked, who actually gave the feedback properly, who actually wrote them down?
তাহলে কি কেন সে নিজেই recognition পাবে
এটা আমি শুনতে যাচ্ছিলাম
আচ্ছা
এটা আজকে আপনারা প্রথম আলোতে দেখছেন না এটা রিপোর্ট যে একজন এসিল্যান্ডার দেখেছেন প্রথম আলো রিপোর্টটা যে আমি একদম আচ্ছা আজকে প্রথম আলো কথা বলছি
আচ্ছা অবশ্যই
থ্যাংক ইউ আমি সরি
না না স্যার আমি একটু
দেখতে দিছি তাই
আচ্ছা ফার্স্ট অফ অল আই রিয়েলি লাইক দ্য আইডিয়া অফ দ্য টিভি রিয়েলিটি শো ইফ ইউ ক্যান অ্যাকচুয়ালি টেক ইট টু ইউ নো দ্যাট লেভেল ইউ নো লাইক ইত্যাদি লেভেল ঠিক আছে আই থিঙ্ক দ্যাট দ্যাট মে হ্যাভ সাম ইনফ্লুয়েন্স দ্যাট আই রিয়েলি লাইক নাও আই হ্যাভ ওয়ান কোয়েশ্চন দ্যাট ইজ ইউ হ্যাভ সাজেস্টেড আ লট অফ থিংস লাইক ইউ নো টিভিসিজ বিলবোর্ডস রেডিওস ওয়ান স্টপ সার্ভিস সেন্টার্স ইন এভরি সাব ডিস্ট্রিক্ট হটলাইন রাইট সো How do you plan to organize the funds for it? I mean, it's going to be a really big project. Who's going to fund you? How are you going to, you know, say
that? Since we are doing something for the government, we would expect...
So it's going to be free?
No, it's not going to be free, but we are going to expect the government to fund services.
We are already running on a budget deficit.
Yes. Budget deficit. I think...
Sir, we see in the long run, it's going to the rewards it's going to yield in the long run is going to surpass the deficit that we have. It's because of the investment that we put right now is going to yield better rewards in the future.
But
that's the
we don't have even enough money
to run the funds.
To run the country,
who will give the funds for the bridging period? We need to have someone to run the funds.
Was it mentioned that we have limited funds?
Mention of it. I'm just
asking.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And of course, this is you were asked to provide a practical solution.
Yes.
So I am asking the practicality.
Sir, what we can do is we have a timeline for this, right? For example, we have the 4 stages plans, and we talked about which plans are going to be done simultaneously. So we are going to make some changes over there, so that you know it takes time. By this time, the amount of money we can you know generate by this amount of time when the first few plans are implemented.
So what's the, what's going to be the source of the fund? Internal, external?
Source of the fund.
Where
the public service delivery itself has some fund right now because it's not totally deficient.
So you're suggesting a lot of new things.
Yeah.
So where is the extra money?
So we are going to divide this in timelines based on the priorities. Not that we are going to do everything together.
No. Divide which, how are we going to have the fund to start it?
If I go to renew my license, I'm not obviously going to do it for free. Or if I go for my passport renewal.
So you're
going
to put
increase the fee on it?
No, increase the fee. But we can gather fund first and then go for implementation of our plan.
So that's already there. That's the fee for coming up to the passport.
We need something.
How about you're employing new people for the complaint management or feedback management, right?
Yeah.
How are you going to pay them? Where is the money coming from? So you set up Apunala, right, in every other union or...
On a stop service center.
Yes. So you need an infra, you need people, you need, say, computers.
Huge infrastructure.
Where is the money coming from? Are you going to increase taxes?
We are not in the scope of paying more tax.
Are you going to bring in the private sector? Or these are answers that we are looking for. What would it be? There are multiple ways of saying
it.
I have one last question. Why 5-1-2?
It's just striked our mind instantly.
Maybe 1+2 is 3 and 3 is something odd and 5 is also odd.
It's because we thought of the numbers of different operating offices, so most of them are
We were basically thinking about GP and proper answer. 5 is a number in the middle, and then 1 is just above it to left, and then 2 is just beside it. So it's 5-1-2. It's very easy to
triangle.
It's very easy to dial. So that's.
But okay, fine.
Why not 2-4-7?
Why not 2-4-7? One, two,
because
three.
It's 5-1-2.
So people usually like the numbers like 5 or 10. So when see it in the beginning, it's like very catchy. And
okay, fine. Okay. But do you know that how expensive hotline is?
No.
This is just a feedback because I have to suffer for it on a day-to-day basis.
Okay.
Because in Grameenphone, we have the largest call center in the country.
Mm-hmm.
And the per minute call, the cost is 30 taka. So we serve around 1/3 of the country, 55 million people, and per minute we have to incur 30 taka.
Okay.
So call center is very, very, very expensive. Okay, so just, you know, this is something you should know. All right. But thank you very much.
Thank you.